Right, Shalom. Wanna give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahweh Shai, double honors to the apostles and the elders of Great Millstone that rule well, peace and blessings to the elect of the nation of Israel, right, wherever they may be, salutations to the brothers who now coming in, brothers who woke up to the fact that they are Hebrew Israelites. Right, this is number one from the Great Millstone Camp in Trinidad. I'm going to do a video basically entitled that I am an Hebrew Israelite. Right, I know African, I know from the Zulu tribe. Right, I am an Hebrew Israelite male. Okay, because we have a lot of people right now gainsaying against this truth, who calling us the Black Hebrew Israelites. That is this clown Elijah Rick Akim or something. So I believe that is the Watchman Report son. He denounced being a Hebrew Israelite. Well, I am announcing being a Hebrew Israelite. Alright, I am an Hebrew Israelite. This whole thing that we're seeing brothers on the highways and the byways pushing this word, they are Hebrew Israelites also. We are waking up. This is the last time, and we are waking up pursuant to prophecy. Right? Pursuant to prophecy, we getting back our flesh, we getting back our skin. This is Romans 11 verse 1. It says, I say then, had the Most High cast away his people, the Most High forbid. I look up that word forbid just to get a better understanding of it.
Strong's G, 3361, May.
Say me, right? No, not less. Root word etymology, a primary particle of qualified negation, whereas uversum G3756 expresses an absolute denial. So it's an absolute denial. Alright? That Yahweh, why Yahweh Shai cast away his people. Okay, because it has some people will say when they read in what is that? When the Mosai said he would do away with the whole seed of Israel, and say, well, God do away with the whole. No, that was just for a period. He just cast them out of his sight. You know, that is all he did. He cast them out of his sight. He get them out of the land. That is all he did. But he didn't do away with his people. He made promises. The Most High is not slack concerning his promise. He's not slack concerning his promise as some men call slackness. So, going back to the scripture, it says, I say then, had God cast away his people? Paul asking a question. Paul say, absolute no. Absolutely no, in other words. Or God forbid. When you look up the word, it means what? An absolute denial. No. For I also am an Israelite of the seed of Abraham, of the tribe of Benjamin. Now, Paul was able back then to trace back his genealogy to Benjamin, to the tribe of Benjamin. Through the Spirit right now, we, in this truth, get traced back to what High Priest Aria coming with the 12 tribe chart from wherever region we come from. Like I from the West Indies, I may very well be of the tribe of Benjamin, but really it don't matter what tribe, really and truly the tribe, whatever tribe you're from, where you might identify with this tribe, you know. But we really and truly cast, because it have scattering. It going had Judites looking like Ephraimites. It going had Ephraimites looking like Simeonites. Simeonites looking like Israel, scattered all over the place. But the basis and the bottom line is that we are Hebrew Israelites. Why? Because our spirit meshes with the word. Our spirit meshes with the word of God. And the word of God say this. Psalms 147:19-20. It says, He showeth his word unto Jacob, which proves to Yahweh Shai, came and died for the nation of Israel, because he is the word. He is the word. So it's only the nation of Israel could be redeemed. He showed his word unto Jacob, his statutes and his judgments unto Israel. He had not dealt so with any nation, and for his judgments they have not known them. Praise ye Yahweh. Praise ye Yahweh. Why? Because you're only dealing with Israelites. So wherever this word is being preached in the world, Israelites going to attain unto it, because they have that spirit in them to attain unto it. You understand? Romans 8:16. It says, The spirit itself beareth witness with our spirit that we are the children of God. That word beareth witness with we spirit. Yahweh Shai spirit beareth witness with our spirit that we is the children of the Most High. Pursuant to prophecy, we would wake up in the last days. Pursuant to prophecy, we would rise up in the last time. Okay? Pursuant to our prophecy. Ezekiel 37:1. It says, Proverbs 21:16. It says, The man that wandereth out of the way of understanding shall remain in the congregation of the dead. Our understanding were in the laws of the Lord. That is what we did understand, and we wandered out of it. Yes, we did. We did wander out of it. Daniel 9:11. It says, Ye all Israel have transgressed thy law, even by departing, that they might not obey thy voice. Therefore the curse is poured upon us, and the oath that is written in the law of Moses. We transgressed the law. We departed. We wandered out of the understanding. Because watch. Deuteronomy 4:5. It says, Behold, I have taught you statutes and judgments, even as Yahweh my power commanded me, that ye should do so in the land whither you go to possess it. Keep therefore and do them. For this is your wisdom and understanding, and your understanding in the sight of the nations, which shall hear all these statutes and shall say, Surely this is a great and wise and understanding people. So that is our understanding, the laws, the statutes, and the judgments of the Lord. And we wandered out of it. So we remain in the congregation of the dead. Hence, therefore, the reason why Ezekiel had to get this role. Ezekiel 37:1. It says, The hand of the Lord was upon me, and carried me out in the spirit of the Lord, and set me down in the midst of the valley, which was full of bones, and caused me to pass by them round about. And behold, there were very many in the open valley, and lo, they were very dry. And he said unto me, Son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, O Lord, power thou knowest. Now these bones is the whole house of Israel. I ain't gonna read the whole thing. Then jump into 11. Then he said unto me, Son of man, these bones are the whole house of Israel. Behold, they say our bones are dried, and our hope is lost. We are cut off for our part. So that is the bones, the whole house of Israel, right? Now, dry bones, basically a bone is eternal life. It have no spirit in it. It's just dead. All Israel was dead. That is us in our dead state. We are getting back our life now. So all those who gain saying and talking shit, but this clown, the Watchman Report's son's book, the Watchman Report's son, about he denounced being a Hebrew Israelite, you fucking asshole. May the Mosai Yahweh Yahushai destroy you. All you gain saying against the truth, may Yahweh Basham Yahushai destroy you. Dr. James White, the Edomite, as Apostle Letter had us call him G-Man, Vocab Malone. Alright? All things fulfilled ministries. Okay? All of you damn Christian, Roman Catholic, paganism, folly. All of you guys who on folly made most high Yahweh Bahasham Yahawashai destroy you all. Because now it's high time to wake up. We are the Hebrew Israelites. The so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Natives. I am an Hebrew Israelite. And all of this is just through faith. Okay? Through faith in the Bible. Because some people don't really believe in the Bible. Some people believe in what them believe in. They don't believe in the Bible. I believe in the Bible. I believe what the Bible says is true. So therefore, I will announce being a Hebrew Israelite. So I'll continue reading on. It says, and caused me to pass by them round about, and behold, there were very many in the open valley, and lo, they were very dry. The word valley mean a lowland. Alright? That is what valley mean. When you look up the word valley, it mean a lowland. Let me look it up. Plain, a level valley. To divide, to break up, to cleave. But the first definition means what? Plain, a level valley. A plain, a wide level valley between mountains. So basically, look it up as a lowland, a level land, a level piece of land, right? A level piece of land. That's what valley means. Okay? So, what is that valley? That valley, Psalms 23, verse 4, it says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me, which is this word. But the valley of the shadow of death, death and hell represents the Edomites and the rulership, mainly America. Now Trinidad followed after the ways of America, so Trinidad is a part of America by extension. Jamaica also is a part of America by extension, because we follow the ways, including China. But the main destruction is going to take place in America. Now, the valley of the shadow of death is mainly America, right? Esau is the man of death, the man of sin is Esau. Sin is the way. Wages of sin is death. And who causes Israel to sin? The righteous is more excellent than his neighbor, but the ways of the wicked seduceth him. Matter of fact, oh my God. It's Proverbs, I believe, is 12 and 26. Proverbs 12 and 26. the righteous is more excellent than his neighbor. Israel is the righteous. But the way of the wicked seduces them. So that is how we sin, through this fucking devil. Alright? He causes us to sin. In the land of the valley of the shadow of death. Because once we sin, we will die. And Esau is that man of sin. The man of sin is the man of death too. And wherever this man of sin dwelling, will have death. So his main province right now is the USA. So that is where the USA have all this debt going on. And all around the world have all this debt going on. Because Job 9:24 states, the earth is given into the hands of the wicked. He covered the faces of the judges thereof. If not, where and who is he? The earth, the so-called white man of the whole earth. So you have debt all over the earth because of him. You understand? Because of him. So, when you go back in Psalm 23, verse 4, you say, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, because death can follow you everywhere you go on this side, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Who is that? Yahweh, Yahweh Shai, and the Spirit. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me, which is the Holy Scripture. That's the comforter. Alright? And that is what Ezekiel was going and preach unto the Israelites in this paragraph, in this word here, in this chapter here. Ezekiel 37 verse 1. The hand of the Lord was upon me and carried me out in the spirit of the Lord and set me down in the midst of the valley in America. So Ezekiel went in the spirit and died over thousands of years ago and saw Israel in this state where they're in here right now, which was full of bones. It was full of bones and caused me to pass by them round about. So Ezekiel was passing around Jacob and looking at them like, wait. And said unto me, son of man, can these bones live? And I answered, O Lord God, thou knowest. Again he said unto me, prophesy upon these bones that they, and say unto them. See, that is why we have to prophesy. The spirit, Psalms, Revelation 19 verse 10. For the spirit of Yahweh is the spirit of prophecy. And Yahweh said in John 14 verse 6, I am the way, the truth, and life. No man cometh unto the Father except through me. So if he is the way, the truth, and life, and his spirit is the spirit of prophecy, once we prophesying, right, as long as we are prophesying, life is going to enter back into our people. Because it's his spirit is what quickens. The spirit, John 6 and 63, it is the spirit that quickeneth, the flesh profiteth nothing. The words that I speak. Yeah. Now it's the news to renew.